When you walk through a storm.
It started maybe into the second week into lockdown when I just phoned one of the old school Reds up. He's a well-known Liverpool fan. You know, he's in his 70s now. He hasn't been too good on his health. So I just gave him a call to see how he was. And after speaking to his wife, I just got the impression that he was possibly struggling, you know, with food and whatever. Because remember at the time, people panicked buying and he couldn't get anything, you know, whether it was toilet paper or meat even, you know, just basic, you know, food. So I phoned Ian Burnham from Fan Support and Food Banks, and Ian went round there within the hour with a big box of, you know, provisions for him, and they were absolutely made up with it all, and we got a call often. And I think I just realised then what it all meant, you know, with what's happening, you know, in the world. And I just thought, some people out there need help in our city.
Put a message out through social media for people to get in touch, and a snowball since then. But prior to that, obviously the SOS has been at the forefront of helping out in the community anyway. A lot of things would have been going on, certainly with Ian Byrne and Dave Kelly from the Blue Union with the food banks. You know, that's been started for, I think it's 3 years now.
We realised this is much bigger than we all thought, so we put it on social media. Now, it wasn't about, look at what the spirits of Shankly do. It was about awareness, what's going on in our city. And then it sort of snowballed from there. We were getting donations from all over the world. You know, really, it was amazing, from Japan, America, Australia. Obviously all over the city, people donating all over Europe. You know, we've had, you know, I'm 3 months on and we're still going with all these food drops for people.
I'm Jane and I work at Morrison's in Speak. So I've been working with the Spirits of Shankly, making food parcels in order for the drivers to take out to deliver across Merseyside.
Fantastic, you know, they couldn't do enough for us. You know, they've been brilliant. Every time you go there, you know, Mono, and the lads will tell you that anyway, the taxi drivers, is that they just do everything for you. They bend over backwards, you know, they put everything to the side to put our bags together as quickly as they can do to get it out to the people. So they've been brilliant, Morrison's.
We create the food parcels and then they reach out to hundreds of families and individuals across Merseyside with the help of all their donations from members and just people who donate in general. So the parcels go out to vulnerable families, elderly who are isolating, pretty much anyone that's sort of in need within this crisis.
Some of the taxi drivers, that when they phone us and they tell us what's happened, you know, when they give food, you know, to some people, and they start crying, they've had no food in, you know, for a long time.
So knocks at the flat, no answer, so we're told if no one's in, pass it into your neighbour, you know, will your neighbour look after the parcel, they're not in. So we knocks at the other flat, flat 3 it was, and little half fella answered, must have been about 80 odds. I said, you don't mind taking this parcel in for your mate, for your neighbour? He went, no. So I had the double drop in the car, and he was like about 80 odd, the elderly fella, little half fella he was. So I thought, you know what, instead of going back to Morrison's, I said, here's one for yourself, 2 bags for yourself. Just seen the look on his face, unbelievable. Just gobsmacked, you know what I mean, that he'd got it. It was only like 2 bags of shopping, but it must have been everything to him. He was like, oh, thank you, are you sure? I went, yeah. I said, it's off the spirit of Shankly. I said, help us here, campaign. I said, you get that in the cupboard there, lad, it's for you, that. Send your neighbours in as well. He was over the moon, and then, I think that's one of the best little drops I've done, you know, the little buzz you get off it.
I run a charity called An Hour for Others, which obviously we link in with all the other charities in the city and organisations, such as the Spirit of Shankly. We're all good Reds basically, and since the lockdown began, we've all just adapted straight away and been providing food and essentials for vulnerable people right across the city, people who are isolated, you know, families who are living in poverty, elderly people who are, you know, struggling and stuff. Yeah, I think from day one, I think it's week 13 now, and from day one, everyone just came together and just, it was as if we were just all ready for it in this city, do you know what I mean? And like, so we've been doing it for 13 weeks, and like I say, I think if there was ever a city that was going to be ready for something like this, it was our city. People just straight away, it wasn't an issue to people. People just got off the backside and just started helping each other, and with our contacts, you know, with Mono and the lads from the Spirit of Shankly, straight away we were liaison together, and no, and we've kept it going for 13 weeks and another delivery from the lads at the Spirit of Shankly.
We seen what was happening all around the country, and in the city, all the stuff was starting to come off shop shelves, people were panic buying. So I thought, why don't I do, I knew we were, it was imminent that we were going to have to shut the coffee shop, so I thought, why don't I turn the shop into a bit of a community hub, because we're right in the middle of, you know, Chilwell Way, which we were in a good area in the city. So I asked members of the community if they could donate any food items that they may have over, or, you know, any care, any essential items that we could create care packages. And once I'd done that, within a couple of days, you couldn't get in the shop for stuff. It was just, it literally exploded. And BBC Merseyside got involved on it. And then once they put it out there, it just, the demand was just overwhelming. It went quite viral on social media, and it was picked up by Liverpool Football Club. And Liverpool's Forbes from Red Neighbours got in touch and said, there's a Liverpool player who wants to get involved. He's seen what you've done, and it's amazing. He wants to support. He wants to pay for 200 care packages, this footballer, and just give them away to charity. So we done that over 4 weeks. We done 50 a week for 4 weeks, and that was just, I was blown away when I got told, but he wouldn't tell us who the player was, which, you know, that's the burning question, which player's done this. And then the final week, they turned around, Forbes turned around and said it was Virgil van Dijk that had done it. So I was just, you know, he's my favourite player anyway. And when I found out that, he's just, what a gentleman. But he didn't want any publicity. But I think a few things got out there, you know, what he'd done. And that's why we were able to go public over it.
It just started back in March when Boris announced that there was going to be a lockdown. And we were doing something with Kirkdale anyway, No Knives campaign, and I just come down to see them over something and just asked them what they were doing for what are they going to be doing anything within the community during the lockdown. I mean, at that stage it only looked like it was going to be 2 weeks or something, and they'd been sponsored for 25 meals a day at that stage. But so we spoke, and they'd already had stuff like that in place, like given out to the community, because they do it at Christmas, so the logistics were already there. So I thought, well, we'll get our heads together and see if we can do anything. And that 25 meals, like, it went up to 90 or something a day.
This week, we'd be a couple of meals shy of 7,000, so we're on our 13th week now, this week, so there's some food going on, like, it's good.
People have been sending money in from all over as well. What I find is, I mean, this area gets bad press, I think, but when times are hard, when it's tough, you know what I mean, they pull together, and people from the area have been donating, people from Scotland have been donating to us. It's like the stuff what these are doing isn't really going on around the country. You've got people from London donating, Scotland, expats, you know, people you are from Kirkdale, living in Australia and America have been donating. So yeah, it seems like the tougher the area, it seems the people get together when times are hard, sort of thing.
Yeah, so we've had donations as well, also from the LFC, who've been dropping off 100 meals every Thursday for us. And we've also had Evan in the community have also dropped off food hampers, food parcels, and whatever they can get hold of, they can drop it here. So we'd like to thank both clubs for supporting us. It's been a great little journey for us all, because, you know, we've all pulled together, and that's what we're here. We've got the facility here, and we've got the lads and the people here who want to help, and we've always have helped, so we're always here for that. You know what I mean? We're more than a boxing club, which is our logo. So, and it's true that we are more than a boxing club, we're here to help everyone.
John Parry, who's been doing Merseyside PPE, you know, John's a member of the union, and his union backed as well. Like, he's been going up and making new PPE for the hospitals and care homes, and not just in Liverpool, but to be up and down the country with it all, to give to other football fans groups like ourselves, and they've been passing out to their local communities.
Hi, I'm John Parry. I am one of the founders of the Merseyside PPE Hub, based here at Studio at Days in Waverty Technology Park. Studio at Days is part of the Lydian Learning Trust, which is made up of Chilwell Sports Science Academy and Days High School. A group of teachers came together to start manufacturing PPE here at the Waverty Park. To date, we're making around 400 to 700 PPE buys a day alone here at the Wavertree base, but also lots of other people who are involved in the Merseyside PPE Hub are also manufacturing PPE visors. To date, we've made over 35,000 PPE visors, which have gone out across Merseyside into care homes, hospitals, paramedics, and to lots of different frontline workers. Also based here at the Merseyside PPE Hub is also Scrub Hub Liverpool, where we're manufacturing scrubs, which are going on to the front line as well. We're working in conjunction with Fan Support and Food Banks as well, and with Ian Byrne, and we've done lots of different projects, including delivering PPE visors across the country to Newcastle, Manchester and Huddersfield, and we're about to send 2,000 visors down to the Transport Union down in London.
The people who you've spoken to, they'd like to, an hour for others, the spirit of Shankly. It only made, and Kirkdale Boxing Club, it only made sense that they were in a position to do this straight from the off.
It's been a real team effort from the SOS. Chris, who does the website and put it all on social media, through to Joe, who's the chair of the Spirit of Shankly. And not forgetting Steph, who's been amazing for us. She collates all the names from text messages and emails and sends them over to Morrison.
We've been very proactive within our own community for a long time now. You know, we'll help anybody out. You know, whether, as I said before, whether it be footballing matters or any other matter, you know, we will do our best. And we have been doing our best within our local community.
Different organisations, whether, you know, it was the Box Lads, the Sands Alpino, Kirkdale Boxing, FICA, City Liverpool, Merseyside, PPE, Spine Cop, and Owl for others. You know, the list was endless doing it. And, you know, they've all, not just us, you know, everyone's seeing what's going on, you know, in the city. And obviously everyone needed help. So it's great when everyone's pulled together. You know, there's such negativity going on with football fans at the moment. Whatever. But this is like football fans being proactive in a city, and I think it's brilliant.